In this video, we will study about the respiration, that is the part of the chapter first of the life process for the class 10. Now, we take here the introduction about the respiration. First of all, what is the respiration? When we start respiration, then what are the mechanism of it and how we can explain it? Then first is the respiration. Respiration is the multi-step enzymatic and oxidative breakdown. Oxidative breakdown of respiratory substrate. Respiratory substrate here. Then, what is the meaning of this reaction? First of all, the multi-step. Multi-step means it not completing in the single step. It takes many steps to complete. Enzymatic means different types of enzymes involve for this reaction to be complete. And oxidative breakdown means presence of oxygen must be there, due to which the complete breakdown of the food will take place here. And the respiratory substrate means the component which undergo oxidative breakdown, and there is the main respiratory substrate is the glucose. Now, this is the general equation about the respiration. Then, what is the respiratory substrate? This respiratory substrate is the substrate which undergo breakdown, and due to this breakdown it releases energy. This compound is known as the respiratory substrate, and most common respiratory substrate here is the glucose form. Now, this respiratory substrate undergo the breakdown, and this breakdown releases energy. Here the most common respiratory substrate is the glucose. Now we can take an example to show the equation here. First of all, there is the main respiratory substrate, that is the glucose molecule. This glucose molecule needs oxygen molecule for its complete breakdown. Point note here that for one glucose breakdown there is the need of the 6 oxygen molecule. In the presence of different enzymes here, this oxygen burns this glucose completely and forms 6CO2 plus 6H2O plus 38 ATP. Means high amount of energy is released here, and this amount of energy when we measure in the kilocalorie, or we can measure it in the kilojoule, then what is the amount? 686 kilocalorie, or you can say the 2870 kilojoule energy released when one glucose molecule get breakdown, or you can say undergo respiration in the presence of enzyme. Then how these ATP produced? These ATP produced when the ADP, that is the adenosine diphosphate, already existed in the cytoplasm, plus inorganic phosphate, that is the braked form. Means when this ATP is formed in our body, this ATP is used for further metabolic process. So this ATP get converted into this ADP and PI. Then after that, when this respiration occur, this PI again joined with this ATP, ADP, and forms ATP here, and this ATP again consists of this amount of energy. Now this is the formation of ATP, how this ATP formation takes place. Now next is the steps of respiration. What are the steps of respiration? First of all, when we explain the respiration, first step is the breathing. Breathing means general exchange of gases is known as the respiration, or you can say the breathing. That is the exchange of gases. Exchange of gases. These exchange of gases means intaking of oxygen and liberation of CO. Means when we take oxygen inside our body, this is known as intaking, or you can say it inhalation. Or when we liberate CO2 from the body outside in the environment, that is known as the exhalation. Means between these two phases, there is the process of respiration to be occur. Because when we take this oxygen, then this process is known as inhalation. And when we remove CO2, then it is known as the exhalation. Means between these two processes, this equation becomes completed and this CO2 is released. So this is the first step of the respiration, that is the breathing part. Next, cellular respiration. Cellular respiration. Cellular respiration means when the breakdown of food takes place inside the cell. Means when this event taking place inside the cell, then it is known as the cellular respiration. And this inhalation and exhalation is only the surface processes. When we take respiration parallel to the photosynthesis, then what are the differences between these two processes, respiration as well as the photosynthesis? First of all, this respiration takes place in all types of cells, but this photosynthesis only in green cells, means the cells which contains chlorophyll in it. Only these cells can perform the photosynthesis. Now, during respiration, there is the presence of oxygen, or you can say oxygen comes inside the cell. But when the photosynthesis occurs, then it liberates oxygen. This liberates oxygen. When this respiration occurs, then its end product, or you can say the gas liberated, is CO2. Liberated gas is CO2. And when the photosynthesis occurs, then it consumes CO2. Now, what are the end product of the respiration? End product is CO2 and water in case of respiration, and in photosynthesis, end product is glucose and oxygen which goes into the atmosphere. Then this respiration liberates energy. Means high amount of ATP is released from here, but this photosynthesis needs energy. It means this need energy in the form of sunlight. Means sunlight must be there to complete the photosynthesis. So on the basis of the energy need, liberation is there. So this process is known as exothermic process, in which heat is released. And this process is known as endothermic process, means for the conversion of the carbon dioxide and water into glucose, there is the special, or you can say the urgent need of energy to be there, and that energy is provided in the form of sunlight. So this reaction is known as endothermic. Now if we draw the overall reaction for both these processes, then what are the different reactions to be there? For the respiration, there is C6H12O6, that is the glucose molecule, combines with 6 oxygen molecule to form 6 CO2 plus 6 H2O and 38 ATP to be released here. And this 38 ATP, we can say 686 kilocalorie energy is released here. But when we take the photosynthetic reaction, then 6 molecule of CO2 and 12 molecule of H2O will take part in the presence of sunlight as well as in the presence of chlorophyll, or you can say the chloroplast. This carbon dioxide and water together forms the 1 molecule of glucose plus 6 molecule of oxygen plus 6 molecule of H2O is liberated here. Now this sunlight is provided in the amount of 686 kilocalorie energy. So when this energy is required here, it is known as endothermic process, and when the heat is liberated, then it is known as the exothermic process to be completed here. Now this is all about the differences between the respiration and the photosynthesis. In the next video, we will take up a detailed account of the respiration.